Okay, so we agreed, Michael, that the problem is pretty hard. It's exponential in the number of features, in this case, n. And there's sort of two general approaches that people have used to try to attack this problem, broadly speaking. The first is called filtering, and the second is called wrapping, with a W, not an R. Hmm. Well, it has an R too, but it starts with a W. And they actually look pretty similar, so I drew these little cartoons, which I hope would make it easier for you to see. So filtering basically works like this. You have a set of features as input. You run them through some algorithm that maximizes some kind of criterion, and then it outputs fewer features and passes those to some learning algorithm that will then use it for classification, say. It could be regression more generally, but you know, without loss of generality, let's assume that we're worried about classification problems here. So you'll notice then that the criterion of how you know whether you're doing well or not is buried inside the search algorithm itself. By contrast, you could do what's called wrapping. And in the wrapping approach, you take in your set of features, your n features, and you run them into this little box that basically searches over a subset of features, asks the learning algorithm to do something with them. The learning algorithm basically reports how well it does, and it uses that to update this new subset of features that it might look for and passes to the algorithm. So this is called filtering because this is a process that filters the features before handing it to a learning algorithm. And this is called wrapping because the search for the features is wrapped around whatever your learning algorithm is. Hmm. You see that?
I think so.
Okay. So you might ask yourself, okay, great. So you've got two different approaches to this. Which one might you pick? And unsurprisingly, there are trade-offs. So let's talk a little bit about what those trade-offs are. Actually, before we do that, Michael, do you have any suggestions for what would be good or bad about filtering versus wrapping?
So filtering, it feels like, is how we were talking about it before. It's this idea of whittling down to a set of fewer features and then handing it over, kind of one thing after the other. An advantage of that seems like it's sort of very flow forward, right? So the features come in, the search does its thing, it hands it over, everybody's got its job. The disadvantage of that, though, is that there isn't any feedback. So the learning algorithm can't inform the search algorithm as to, hey, you know, you gave me this feature, but without that, you took away that feature, but without it, I'm having a lot of trouble doing the learning. Maybe you should put that one back in. The wrapping approach, I guess, would allow for that.
In fact, that's exactly right. So as I said before, in the filtering case, the criterion or criteria is built inside the search algorithm itself without reference to the learner. By contrast, in wrapping, the criteria or criterion, if it's a single one, is actually built inside what the learner wants. It's built inside something like classification error or sum of squared errors or whatever it is that you measure your learner by. So we can write those down and stare at them for a little while.